buildings and their construction are responsible for around one-third of global energy consumption. That's shocking, but it doesn't have to be that way. Bahoa Preschool, close to Indonesia's capital, Jakarta, is going a revolutionary way. Despite the tropical climate, it was deliberately designed without air conditioning.
AC actually consumes quite a lot of energy in buildings like schools and other public buildings. So the challenge is how to create good ventilation and good lighting.
The strategy behind this is called passive design. It uses natural light, heat, and air movement to reduce the need to light, warm, or cool a building mechanically. Natural climate control can save lots of energy. Something the building sector is in dire need of, says Iwan Prijanto, chairperson of Indonesia's Green Building Council.
The carbon dioxide from the building sector contributes to 39% of all the carbon dioxide in the world. It's the largest sector responsible for global warming, which leads to climate change and will worsen in the future.
So it's not only agriculture, the garment sector, and transportation that have a large share in harming our climate. How to plan a building that can save energy? Cross-ventilation plays a crucial role in the green concept of architect Adi Purnomo. He paid attention to existing environmental conditions, like wind direction, and planned the building's layout and access to fresh air accordingly.
The point is to try reading the paths of the sun and the paths of the wind that are always eastward and westward, so the orientations of these classrooms eventually line up going east to west. That way, the warming due to the opening of the window does not occur in this whole design.
Fans with low wattage are only used when there is no wind. At Pahoa Preschool, the plants on the wall help keep the building cool. Also, the grass on the green rooftop cools the classrooms underneath. Each measure makes a difference of up to 1 to 2 degrees Celsius. Natural light reaches the ground floor through openings in the roof. Clay Nesler from the World Resources Institute sees Pahoa Preschool as a model for the future.
That is a great project. It includes many of the elements of the best in passive design. So they've done everything necessary to eliminate the need for air conditioning. Plus, you know that building is going to be very, very healthy because of all the fresh air going through it.
Teresia Moretta is the preschool's project director. Her vision is that the students learn to adapt to their natural climate instead of being in air-conditioned premises all the time.
The initial reaction was that some were very strongly against this school not using air conditioning. Some say that their children are constantly sweating. It's also a question of prestige. My child was born in a hospital using AC, left the hospital using AC, goes home using AC, but now is going to a school without using AC.
Teresa Moretta says that after a couple of months, the parents' attitude changed, also because the children got sick less often. Energy experts stress that changing people's mindset toward air conditioning is also important.
Energy efficiency is not only technology, but it's also the behavioral issue. For example, you know, not using light in the place we don't need, not air conditioning the hallways or the unnecessary places where we don't need, right? So, you know, making air conditioning unit should cool the people, but not the space.
At Pahoa Preschool, the plan to cut energy consumption works. Pahoa now needs 50% less energy per square meter than an average Indonesian school.
This could be a role model for green building because it proves they don't have to be expensive. In fact, this design shows that eco-friendly solutions can be very, very simple.
A simple design with a big impact on the building's energy consumption and an inspiring idea to tackle climate change bit by bit.